yourself in wonderful world. Everything feels like your fantasy.
I hear rumors of the murder victims returning from the beyond. You know, the ones killed by the children of Etro. Apparitions go against the Order's beliefs. I suspect this is all nothing more than a wild rumor fanned by superstition.
I saw a woman with rose-colored hair around these parts the other night. Quite mysterious. She seemed to have been inspecting the crime scene. There was something almost ethereal about her presence. She was something.
Rumor has it the victims of the children's rituals come back to haunt the area at night. I want to see it for myself, but I'm not stupid enough to walk around after dark.
A ghost was spotted in the area where that woman was killed. Everyone's talking about it. My friend claims to have seen something strange late at night, but I'm not so sure I believe her.
A lot of strange rumors are going around.
This broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. It is now midnight. Please pray. Let us thank God, who in his wisdom will build us a new world.
I wasn't in any state to introduce myself at that time, I'm afraid.
You're one of the women who was killed by Etro's heretics. It was your resemblance to me that got you killed. It was because of me that you died.
Yes, but I don't blame you. All is part of God's plan. It was my destiny to die here so that I could meet you, Savior.
You're saying God intended for you to die like this?
I believe so. I believe I was meant to die and gain enlightenment. I know because I was a member of the Order and learned all about the teachings of God. I'm to share with you my knowledge and help guide you on your journey. Savior, you must be aware that in this world, new life hasn't been born for hundreds of years. Do you know why that is?
I've never given it much thought, but I suppose that's part of his plan too. A dying world can't support a growing population. And that's what the Almighty Buenavelza chose as his solution. Is that it?
No, I'm afraid that's not the case. It wasn't due to his plan. It was because of the goddess's disappearance.
Because of Etro? How?
In this world, Etro is believed to be the goddess of death. Her followers are heretics. Ones who go against society's ways. But the true Etro, she was the goddess that provided new life with a soul and a spirit.
And now that she's gone, there's no one out there to take her place. Anything born into this world would be nothing more than an empty vessel.
Reincarnation isn't a part of the world's cycle anymore. Dead souls don't return to this world in a new form. And that's why no new life is born. This problem, it doesn't just affect our world. According to legend, the Almighty Buenavelza will appear before us one day, and when he does, he will recreate heaven and earth. But that leads to the question, when this happens, who will breathe life into the new world?
That's a good question. With the goddess gone, I suppose someone needs to fill her shoes.
Yes. Otherwise, the circle of life will remain broken, and the new world stagnant. You have a duty as the Savior. If you really care about what happens to us in the new world, you have to find a way to do what Etro once did.
That's a hell of a tall order. Finding a replacement for a goddess. But I want to thank you for telling me this, and I won't forget what you told me. You have my word.
That's all I need to hear, to be completely honest. I don't know if you can save us all, but I know that if I have to put my faith in someone, it's you.
What just happened? Was I able to save her soul? But that's not possible. I thought that wasn't within my powers.
What was that light? Did you say something?
Who are you?
You of all people should know who I am. And what happened here? Think about it.
Your hair color. I guess I do know what happened. You were a victim of Etra's fanatics, weren't you?
That's right. When I was alive, I spent my days as one of God's soldiers, keeping those heretics in line. It wasn't easy, but under the Order's authority, I worked day and night to keep the peace. That's probably why I was targeted.
It was certainly courageous, going against such a dangerous organization. Do you know anything about the Shadowhunter?
Rumor has it he's their leader, a renegade rebelling against the established Order. Another one of society's outcasts. His actions weren't without good reason. In all fairness, we brought it on ourselves. The Order went through a dark period. A lot of mistakes were made back then. The Elders used their monopoly on food and goods to enforce the law.
Do as we tell you or starve to death. Neither's much of a choice, is it?
Of course, when you start reducing food supplies, what happens? The weak and innocent go hungry too. Then one day an incident occurred that shocked everyone. Someone stole and redistributed the food reserves to the children of Etra. Many of them were on the edge of starvation.
A heroic bandit.
Yes. Rumor has it that during his operation, he snuck into the quarters of one of the elders and left a message on their pillow while they were sleeping. A bold move, huh? The Shadowhunter will seek justice. The Order got scared, and began distributing provisions to everyone again.
It's strange hearing the stories I've missed while I was asleep. So much has happened in the past 500 years that I know nothing about. We never crossed paths when you were still alive, and I can't even begin to imagine what you must have gone through during your lifetime.
I just wanted to pass on my stories before I disappeared forever. It's an honor to get to share them with you of all people. I appreciate you giving me your time. Thank you.
Even though their lives were taken from them, they can.
The day has finally come when I get to meet the Savior.
Are you... You must be one of the heretics' young victims.
Yes, that's right. But looks can be deceiving. I'm not so young anymore. It might be hard to tell, but I've seen many more years than you have.
I'm sorry. I'm the reason you were killed. It's my fault.
Oh, stop it. Don't look so solemn. It's not like you plunged a knife through my heart. Besides, it was a fitting way for me to go.
How could it be fitting?
When I was alive, the Almighty God Bonavelsa spoke to me. He told me I was to save the souls of those in need. I devoted my entire life to carrying out the plan he had laid out for me.
If what you say is true, that would make you a savior too.
No, it's not like that. It's not like that at all. I wish I was like you, but I'm just a fraud that thought she was chosen by God. After I died, I realized something. It was just an echo in my head that I turned into something else because I wanted to hear God so badly. I know you must think I'm just a big fool, but will you save me, Savior?
You have no idea how much I wish I could. I just don't have the power to save the dead.
What a pair we make. The one who is actually chosen by God, and a fraud who thought she was chosen by God, and neither can do a thing. I tried, though. I tried and was never able to save a single soul. At the very least, I wish I could have saved my own.
Looks like a rose, but